Welcome, Chris. Hello. Glad to join you here at Google I.O. Can you give us a brief introduction to your company, please?
Sure. Well, my name's Chris. I work at a company called Norex, which is in Halifax in Nova Scotia, Canada. We do a lot of standard websites. We're starting to get into Google App Engine type apps and integrating contacts, documents, and using different Google APIs to make the customer experience to the people that are using our apps a little more seamless with their existing contact list and existing documents.
So can you talk to us about the features of the Contacts API that you're using?
Sure. The application we're building right now is basically taking the Contacts API and adding a little bit more rich metadata to that. So it's a CRM app, and so we might have other things associated with these contacts and customers. The contacts can be turned into customers, which would have projects or milestones associated with them. So we're taking those contacts and keeping them in sync with the Google contacts and moving data back and forth in between the two, but also adding richer metadata on the App Engine side of things.
So what are your favorite features of the Contacts API?
One of the things I really liked about it is that you get a really full set of data back from Google. So you're not limited to one email address, one address, one phone number. You can add all sorts of other data to it. I mean, you can say that this is a work phone number, this is a a home address. So you get a whole bunch of other information about them. You have notes fields, you have all that sort of stuff. So yeah, it's one of the things that has helped us, and we can actually take some of our metadata and maybe it gets turned into a note and put on the onto the Google contacts where there wasn't a note before.
And if you had any suggestions for the Contacts API, what were some of the one or two things that you'd like to see?
Not so much for the Contacts API. One of the things I noticed though was for off-sub or client login, for actually getting access to that that data, is the process is a little convoluted, only because there's so many different types of logins. There's the standard Gmail logins, there's Google Apps for Domains logins. The documentation was a little confusing. It was all there once you dug deep enough, but it was a little confusing to begin with on how, I don't want access to my Gmail contacts, I want access to my @norex.ca contacts. So getting that level of detail from the documentation and from the code was a little confusing at first. We finally worked around it. But yeah, that was one of the kind of gotchas that we initially had.
So speaking on security, what security are you using? OAuth or OAuthSub?
We're using OAuthSub. It's vanilla OAuthSub, really. It's just a standard token that gets upgraded to a session token and saved so that the user doesn't have to go back and re-authenticate every time they use it. So it's pretty vanilla awesome.
And you also mentioned you're using the Dockless API. How are you using that in the application?
Yeah, we're just starting to do that, to be honest. It's so for the CRM app that we're just starting to write here, it's they might have contracts or spreadsheets or other documents that might need to be associated with a project or with a customer or what need be. So just displaying that, the list of documents associated with the with a person, that's kind of how we're using it.
And what are your favorite features of Dockless API?
We haven't really used it that in depth. We've mostly been focusing on the Contacts API. So far, I mean, the big win is that you can take a list of documents associated with a model and say, here, this is the contract. You can go and edit that, view it, print it off, do whatever.
And do you have any feature requests on the Dockless API?
Not sure that I do. One of the talks I went to this morning, they were talking about exporting and that sort of thing. That was a pretty cool talk. One of the things I'd like to see that you can work around right now is you can kind of a PNG or JPEG preview of the document, which you can work around by exporting as a PNG and that kind of thing. But it'd be really great if in the XML that you return, if you had a link to this is a thumbnail of what this document looks like.
Great. Well, Thanks, Chris, and we wish you well here at Google I.O.
Thank you.